All right, so Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist of the Roses. Let's go. Because when I think Yu-Gi-Oh! I think ancient history, not ancient, I think history of warring factions and stuff like that. That's good. I do not know enough about War of the Roses to make a proper joke, but yeah. So some of you may be wondering, Nick, aren't you already playing a Yu-Gi-Oh! Game? Two, actually. You have your series with Carlos where you play Legacy of the Duelist and he uses the same two decks and you try and come up with three new decks every part. And then there's also the series The Falsebound Kingdom, which you're like 20 parts into. Why aren't you playing one of those? Well, I'm glad you asked, random internet commenter. Since playing Digimon World Next Order, I've got an influx of new subs, and typically people are more likely to click on the first part of something than the 20th part. So I thought I would take this small moment to record something new that everyone can enjoy instead of, you know, the people who've been here for a while. So thought I'd try Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist of the Roses, which was next up on the list after Falsebound Kingdom. So we're just playing a little early. Be honest, probably only going to do one part, maybe a few, but I'm not going to, like, just completely abandon Falsebound Kingdom. We will finish it. We're too close not to. Oh, this is ancient history. 500 years ago? Come on. That's... Please, come on. I don't feel bad anymore. Not the War of the Roses happened in like the 1800s. British Empire in the 1480s. The War of the Roses, a power struggle between the houses of Lancaster, Red Rose, and York, White Rose, decide a royal successor was nearing an end. I don't know why I'm going into an Australian accent, just leave me alone. With the Yorkists well in the lead, the reign of Richard III was but a step away. And in France, Yugi, that's Henry Tudor, thank you, the last Lancastrian heir, was being forced to live a life of exile. Lancastrian forces were rendered powerless by ancient cards of sorcery wielded by Seto and his seven followers, who known as the Rose Crusaders, served under the flag of Lord Crawford, a powerful Yorkist nobleman. Lacking a duelist to champion their cause, defeat was imminent for the Lancastrians. In England, duel card games were still at the fledgling stage. Thus, the Lancastrians had to look elsewhere for a duel master capable of facing the rosing craze in battle. With this in mind, Margaret My Beaufort of Lancaster secretly requested a high druid to summon a duelist from another age. What the fuck is going on? I've played this game, and this is still... I thought maybe I was as a kid I didn't understand it. This makes less sense as an adult, because I understand what they're trying to say, but it just doesn't... Whatever. Wait, so they performed an ancient summon. Well, what are they summoning? Is it Stonehenge, really? It's Shimon McMoran. I know it says Simon, but much like Gurren Lagann, if you watch the sub, then it's pronounced Shimon. Summoned from the mystical circle of red and white roses, the one capable of harnessing pure power. There was a truth to the legend of the Rose Duelist. Lady Margaret, I did it! Now we have the means for defeating the evil forces of Rosencriss. Oh, my apologies, my excitement. I'd forgotten I was in the presence of the Rose Duelists. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Shimon McMoran, High Druid and Servant of Lancaster. Do you guys always pay your debts? Guys, get it? Game of Thrones. May I be so bold as to ask the name by which the Rose Duelist would like to be known? Well, Rose Duelist, me, would like to be known as Nick, because that is my name. Seems fitting. Nick, a fine name indeed. Now, here's the situation. The year is 1485, and you're currently in Stonehenge near Salisbury, England. Alright, go on. British Empire is in turmoil with the House of Lancaster's rightful claim to the throne being challenged by the Yorkist usurpers. You know I'm American, right? Why would I care? This isn't America. That's the American way, is to not care about the rest of the country. Do you guys have Islamic terrorists? Because, I mean, then I'm all over it. I'm ready. You guys, are we fighting terrorists? Just call Kaiba and his enemy terrorists, then I'm all of a sudden all gung-ho. That's all it takes, because I'm all for the war on terror. Power struggles referred to as the War of the Roses. Well, I'm not interested then. I don't know what to tell you. A name based on the badges used by both sides. A red rose for the Lancastrians and a white rose for the Yorkists. Right now, our kingdom is threatened by the Yorkists and their wrongful claim to the throne. Well, I don't know your history. Maybe they have the right claim. Like, I'm just going off what you're telling me. All because the Yorkists enjoy the support of the Rose Crusaders and their sorcerous white rose cards. Using our red rose cards, we summoned you, Nick, to this day and age. We hoped that your dueling experience would defeat the Rose Crusaders. and lead us to victory. Well, you're in luck, because I will. You will help us, of course. You will. Foolish of me to even doubt where your loyalties lie. Rumor has it only the legendary Rose Dealer stands a chance against the power of the Rose. We appreciate any help you can provide against them. Before I forget, I should warn you that the rules to dueling differ here from that of your age. Here in England, dueling is governed by what is known as the perfect rule. In addition to is this how people have to duel in England? In addition to several minor distinctions, there are two major differences. One is the existence of movement or positioning, the other is the deck leader concept. These are two aspects of dueling that were lost in the process when the ancient sport of duel monsters was adapted to card form. Right, so it didn't exist in ancient Egypt, like when Season 5 takes place, and like when several other things take place. Like, Forbidden Memories didn't have this, but you guys developed it and then lost it in between now and then. Shimon, do you take me for a fool? Are you trying to front me on my Yu-Gi-Oh knowledge? Perfect Rule represents these lost rules that were miraculously revived here in England. See here, this is where his story's starting to fall apart. Shimon, I don't know if I trust you. For one, you're blinking on the left, but not in your top portrait, so I don't know if you've got a clone or something, or if that's just like a vision. Perhaps Practice Duel will serve better than an explanation, shall we? I should, but no. First, Nicky must select a deck to duel with. It is important that you feel the vibrations of a deck leader. The minute resonations that ring true to your soul. Cards themselves draw their power from the energies of the Ancient Ones. The deck leader acts as an intermediate between the Ancient Ones and the deck wielder. Nick, it is essential that you select a card leader whose rhythm matches the stirrings of your soul. Here are the several decks from which to choose. Give it some serious thought and make your selection. Choose carefully, for the deck you select will guide the destiny of your duels. Fairy King Truesdale. I have that card in Duel Links. The Patrician of Darkness. Heyo, two-headed behemoth. Main races: dragon, spellcaster, and winged beasts. This one is insects, plant, and beast warriors. Or that might just be regular beast. This one is zombie, fiend, warrior, and plant. Man, I am all about dragons and spellcasters. Also dark and light, and I'm totally about that. This one's only dark and earth. This one's dark, earth, water, fire, or water and wind. Yeah, I'm all about this one. Let's do it. I can get behind Twin Thunder Behemoth. No, fuck, it's not the same. It's just Twin-Headed Behemoth. It's not Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon. Ah, I see you've stuck to your deck. So that's the effect of the Celtic Rose cards. It looks like there's some truth to the rumor the Red Rose cards are capable of the time transformation. Who's there? Obviously Kaiba. It's been some time since the Battle of Barnett, old one. Also, leave it to fucking Kaiba to literally wear a Blue-Eyes head on his fucking chest. Coming from the man who has a Blue-Eyes white jet, then it's not a surprise. What brings you here? Only a member of the Rose Crusaders may call me by that name. If you may recall, I told you once before that you may only address me as Seto. Or does memory fail you, old man? I thought you were much more, like, preferred to be called Kaiba, which is weird to me. And you must be the dreaded Rose Duelist. I must admit, there's a certain aura of power emanating from you. There's no way this is the real Kaiba. Kaiba would never admit that there's someone as potentially strong other than him. I believe an introduction is in order. I, Seto, leader of the Rose Crusaders. You can tell because the music has changed. There are members of our little group who prefer to call me by my name of C. Rosengrr. I ask you again, what brings you here, Seto? Mind your manners, old man. Why else would you bring me here? I've come for the Red Rose cards, or what else bring me here? After all, it was you who showed me how the summoning capabilities would evolve when the Red Rose cards are combined with the transport powers of the White Rose cards. You aren't thinking of attempting the Forbidden Rose summoning. If so, the Red Rose cards must never fall into your evil hands. Card sorcery taps into the powers of the Ancient Ones. By their very nature, each card is a double-edged sword that can cut both ways. That's what a double-edged sword is, Shimon, keep up. The Rose cards alone harness tremendous power. There's no telling what horrors one might unleash to the world by combining both red and white. I mean, pink? I will sacrifice my own life if need be to prevent anyone from uttering the Spell of Doom. Spell of Doom? Fool! The 16 red and white Rose cards grant power over all. Druid legend has twisted the true meaning of these cards. We Rose Crusaders have sworn to create a utopia free from the ravages of war, because that always works. We intend to accomplish this with the power of the cards. We shall do by extending the rule of Richard III. throughout the known world. It fucking weirds me out that they say Richard 3 instead of Richard, like, I. By the way, it was clever of you to form a circle of red roses within the white rose barrier. Summon the rose duelist. What? You're foolish to come alone. The area is surrounded, and if you wish to leave with your life, you will do so by handing over the red rose cards. Me, a fool? Then what about you? Are you fool enough to actually believe the red rose cards would remain here in my possession? Right after the stumbling, I had the cards dispersed among our best duelists to keep them from tainted hands. What a coincidence. Kaiba did the same thing. Then you leave me with what one option? I shall enlist the aid of your precious rose duelist. You take leave of your senses, and you speak too soon, old man. Heed my words, duelist. If you wish to return to your proper time period, you will require 16 cards of the red and white roses. The red and white positions must be laid out in reverse of the summoning order to send you home. You know the spell? Since you need the 16 rose cards just as much as we do, I propose a partnership. Help us gather the cards, and I shall guarantee your return after we've achieved our ultimate goal. An absurd proposal! Do you think that the Honorable Nick would even lend an ear to your ridiculous proposal? Shimon, he's Seto Kaiba. He is a main character. You're only in the video games. Like, I don't know, it's kind of a tough choice. Can you be so sure, old man? Let me see. Shimon's side has 8 of the red rose cards, while my side, the Rose Crusader, has possession of 8 of the white rose cards. As the numbers are even, simple arithmetic indicates you could side with either of us. But I'm sure you'll take into account who's winning this war. After all, who was desperate enough to summon you in the first place? I think it's quite clear which side is better positioned to send you home. Kaiba straight up makes a good point. Like, this isn't even like Kaiba's, like, ridiculousness. That's a very good point. Nick! Well, hold on. Okay, you know what? That's a nice touch. The fact that they did the N and then Nick, that's... You don't really see that when you... In the games where you can choose your own name. Like, usually they're just like, they don't have the technology, I guess, but they took the first letter of my name and then made it so it was like he was stuttering. I like that. I've come from, like, a writing standpoint. I like the idea that they, like, kind of play with it a little bit. So, Shimon, you've won me over. I'm not even kidding. That's the whole... That's not true. I was going to pick the side anyway. Heed not the words of this power-hungry lunatic. Shimon, must you resort to name-calling? I'm hurt. I'll tell you what, why don't we leave the decision to our dear duelist? After all, Shimon, the duelist's future is not for us to decide now, is it? Well, yes, but... Splendid, I'm keeping with the tradition of the old temple gardens? I offer you a choice, duelist. Here are 2 roses. The white represents me, and the red for old Shimon here. For the sake of justice, choose the red rose. Stand by my side, duelist. Choose the white rose. So, I mean, it's good versus evil, essentially. And I don't think I can choose evil. I'm not first anyway. Now, if there's a trophy for picking evil first, then absolutely. But I mean, I have no reason to. So, I'll side with good old Shimon. Holy shit! Are we 14 minutes in? I've done nothing but talk this whole time. Are you kidding me? How disappointing. Oh well, you made your choice, and I respect that. For now, I'll guarantee you safe passage until you've met with Yugi. After all, I wouldn't want our little game to end too quickly. That wouldn't be sporting. Now this is the Kaiba I know. I look forward to the day when we meet again. Duelist, until then. But I won't meet him right away, of course. Can you imagine if Kaiba was the first one you faced, and you just had to lose over and over and over until you win? Oh, let's get the same music as Forbidden Memories. Or not Forbidden Memories. False Mountain Kingdom. Yugi, sitting in the throne again. Typical Yug. Nick, I present Prince Yugi, last prince of Lancaster, true Welshman, and the hope of... What? I don't even know what's going on. And the hope of we who call ourselves Celts. Whatever. My lord, may I present Nick, the Rose Duelist. You serve us well, Shimon. My mother was wise in summoning you from Scotland. You honor me, sire. Yugi doesn't have a mother? What is this? Duelist, I am Yugi. Actually, Henry Tudor is my name. No, it's not, but I'll find it tiresome. You may call me Yugi. You are named Yugi, and that is all you are named. Sure, Shimon explained our situation, but it's only right that I request your services myself. I need you to return to England and put an end to the threat of the Rose Crusaders. Their white rose cards form a barrier that prevents my armies from setting foot on British soil. There's only 8 white rose cards. There's no way they can form, like, a barrier. Although we Celts of the red rose cards, we are but inheritors who are unable to wield their full power. In the hopes of reversing our fortunes, we gambled on a druid legend that spoke of a rose duelist. According to the same legend, one must use a deck whose cost is lower than an opponent's to capture a rose card of another color. I believe that is important to keep this in mind. The cost of your deck should not exceed the cost of your opponent's deck. I would like you to know that our resources have been pressed to the limit, but requiring us to invade England by August. My troops will land in Milford Haven, Wales, and March on Having all of the Rose Crusaders out of commission by this time would prove to be ideal, but as that might prove difficult, any reduction of their force would be appreciated. Rightless Park Company and reunite in Bosworth. Simone will provide you with the details. So where and when we'll meet once more. We won't, like ever. My mission is all about just fighting enemies. I don't actually get to team up with anyone. That's the way this game is played. Alright. So we have Twin-Headed Behemoth, and we can choose between Rex or Weevil. I forget who's, like, supposed to, I think you're supposed to fight Weevil first. And as you can see, our deck cost is already just about the same as Weevil's. So there's not any, like, editing I can really do to it. I kind of just have to be better than him. They gave Rex a different hat. That's weird. Alright, well, off we go. Master, choose a destination. Alright, chill. Let's, first off, save so that when I lose to Weevil, I can reload the save. Alright, thank God I didn't do the tutorial. Can you imagine?
So you're the legendary Rose Duelist. Prepare to face the sting of my insect deck.
Nick, your Weevil's amazing. I know. Alright, so this is the first duel. 18 minutes in. So, for those who've never seen Duelist of the Roses, imagine chess mixed with Yu-Gi-Oh! And that's more or less it. Sort of has some elements from Season 3, the filler season, where they have Deckmasters. So, the best way to do it is to move your Deckmaster forward, and then you press square, summon, and then they'll be able to move forward. I think the cards more or less do the same as they did before. This is not a 4-star card, there's no way. That has way too high stats for a 4-star. Pretty sure that's 5 stars. But anyway. I forget how to read effects. Triangle? Nope, hang on. Returns enemy monster to opponent's deck for reshuffling when the card is flipped face up in battle. Good. And then, let's see your power-up card. You cannot use the dragon once, that's not great. Alright, so, first things first. Forget how to... Okay, so you can kind of choose... Or maybe you can. I thought I could choose whether I wanted to... Oh, okay. So you can, before you move it, you can flip it up or down. As long... I think it's... I'm trying to remember. As long as it's... Oh, okay. So to move it, it can't be... you can't move it if it's in defense position. You have to keep it in place. I'm trying to remember the rules as I go. I know the basics, but I don't remember the finer points. We don't see our opponent's cards. He kind of just goes on his merry way. And as the game progresses, you'll gain more of your cards back, or you'll gain more cards like this right here. So by summoning Wall of Illusion, I used, I think I used 4 stars, and you gain 3 stars per turn. So I can only summon a 3-star monster at this point. So we're going to play, I'm going to play a 2-star one, and hope for the best. I think the summoning sort of works like... I'm not 100% sure, but I think the summoning works like it did in Forbidden Memories, and that you can just kind of, I think you can fuse randomly, and you might get lucky, but I don't think it's as much. It's been a while since I've played. Fuck your card. It's gone. I don't even get to see what it is. Alright. Trying to... So, there are two ways to win. By life points, you can, so this is my strongest card I have yet. So you can win either by attacking the opponent directly, or by just winning by battle damage against their cards. Can I move you while you're in defense position? No, I can't. This is kind of annoying. Well, I don't know what to do. Just form a defensive line, I guess. Yeah, so as the duel goes, as the duel goes on, they'll get stronger and stronger cards, and things will get more and more annoying for me. Plus, so he also has the bonus of his cards being better in the forest. So I may have to lose a couple times before I even beat him. Also, shout out to this game having better card effects than Legacy the Duelist, a fucking PS4 game. Like, at least every card has an attack in this one. Legacy of the Duelist, it's like, Dark Magician, Blue Eyes, Red Eyes, we're fine. That's all you need. So that's not a great start. In fact, it's a bad start. I think the best way to counter Weevil early on is to play, play a field spell, because then his cards loses their massive power up. Just randomly trying to fuse things. So see, this works. Those cards don't normally fuse. I got Cyber Soldier, which is okay, I guess, but it's not what I was going for. So it's kind of like a good, like, last-ditch move, I guess. Like, this isn't going to do anything. Fiends don't mix with... Okay, I was wrong. What do you got for me? Cool. I'm pretty sure I just used this card. Oh, no, wait, whoa. That's a strong card. I could use that. That surprised me. It's face down, so I don't know if he even saw it either. Okay, alright. So I think the turn, I don't know if that's because of his field spell, but you can move two if you're face up, I think. So flipping it up and then moving. Alright, so this is not gonna work, but I'm about to destroy him, so that's good. I haven't decided if I want to keep these on. Let's move it along just because of how long I had to do in the beginning of just talking. So now this would normally be pretty dangerous because he's right there. Oh no. Cocoon of Evolution. I had to get the fuck out of here. Okay, so... Oh good, Mountain. That works. So, well... Shit. It does and it doesn't. It works because, he'll lose his bonus, but so will I, because now my bonus is the Rose Specter of None. Or, I'm sorry, they have a bonus. So let me kill this thing first. I think unless he pulls some bullshit, I should have the advantage. Okay. Good. But I really need to get over to his Larva Moth. I don't know how long, because I know normally it's like, right, I think normally it's like 4 turns. I don't know how long it is in, this game. I hope it's just as long. Oh no, it's 2500. I can't beat it. That's troublesome. That's going to turn into a Great Moth, and I have no defense against that. Okay, well, let me think. So, I didn't summon any monsters, so my hand stays the same, which is not ideal. But, okay, we have Fairy Dragon. I wonder if I can make a monster, and then that's also a dragon, then I might be able to do this. But I kind of got to keep playing with it until then. Fairy Dragon might work if I can... Oh, man. I could take a super risky step here and try and combine these two, and I might get Beast or Black Dragon of the Jungle. I forget, Bee Jungle Dragon King? I forgot what it's called. It's from Forbidden Memories. But if I can get that, and then I can get... I don't know. Let's see. Let's just move forward. I'm going to try and charge him. Giant Flea, normally 1500. Oh, man, this is tough. So yeah, not expecting to win first time. This game has a pretty high difficulty curve. At least I think so. Other people, I'm sure, are going to be like, ah, blah, 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 it's super easy. Oh, you're just bad. I'm like, maybe, but I don't think I'm that bad. Okay, he moved now, and he summoned a monster in my way. Or he didn't, okay. I think I can only move two spaces, though, so I shouldn't be able to beat him, unless he's trying to trap me. The other strategy here is to just beat him before he can summon anything. Let me see. So I have Fairy Dragon there. So let me try this. And then I don't think I'm gonna get a monster here. But if I end with Zaragun, then it's water monster. So maybe I can get like Sea Serpent. I don't know. Nope, nothing. All right, fair enough. So yeah, I'm closing in on him. I can move diagonally too. So if I move here, I think I should be able to attack him no matter what. That's the other thing. You can set spell cards, and sometimes they'll activate their effects, but most of the time it'll just okay. He can't move because he's in defense position, so that's good. Ooh, I didn't think about that. I kind of left myself open. Ooh, I'm just gonna attack him first. So this is gonna deal direct damage to his life points, which I'm all about. Actually, it seems like he's trying to move that forward. I wonder if I could try and get some point damage to him. What do you do? I don't remember. You're not a defect monster. That's weird. Let's go to slip face up in battle. The opposing enemy is spellbound for one turn. I am all about that. So now I'm just going to play smart, I think, and just kind of hunker down a little bit, build a wall. Nobody can get past it, and then that should be good. So this should be my first big attack on it. Now, if Great Moth gets summoned, I have no defense against it. The only saving grace is that I'm pretty sure he'll get summoned over here and won't be able to come attack me in one turn. I keep meaning to check his Larva Moth to see how many turns it takes, and then I keep forgetting. Alright, well, regardless, it looks like I did it. Alright, what's his card? That's not that strong of a card. Oh, but he has an effect where he spellbounds them. Okay, that's alright. Nightmare Scorpion's another... I'm pretty sure that's another normal monster. So I think they added a bunch of effects to cards, which is pretty cool. I like that. I can dig it. So the other thing about Deckmasters is that they can gain different abilities and stuff like that, but you can never use them as cards. Like, I can never fight with Twin-Headed Behemoth unless I make him not my Deckmaster. But I think they gain abilities the longer you use them as Deckmaster, so it's confusing. It's, again, I'm going just off memory. I've done no research into this because I'm a scrub. But I think that's how this works. I should look up a list of like fusion stuff though, just so I can remember how to play this. Alright, and pretty sure I just won. Because he did not properly secure his spot. Like he didn't defend himself properly. I had no business winning that. But I'll totally take it. I win! Guys, I'm the wiener. Oh, so that's right. So you can spin the wheel, and I think it's not... I don't think it's worth getting multiple of the same card, unless you're going for that. But you can potentially get as many cards as... You can potentially get three different cards, and it's all from their deck. I'm going for Cocoon of Evolution. Damn it. Oh, this one's harder. I can't line it up as well. Yes! Alright, Giant Flea would be okay. I see that Beetle too. I think that's Remove Trap. That might be a better one. Oh, I didn't see it. Well, we got Basic Insect. So, one Cocoon of Evolution. That's good. I can kind of throw that in the background and just hope it, turns into Great Moth. I hope it doesn't need to be on a forest panel, because that would be less than bueno.
How? No! I lost! This can't be happening!
I mean, it can, and it did. So we got our first Rose card, also Weevil's picture in the top right. So this unlocks two more duelists. I think Rex unlocks two more. Oh god. I know that field. I am not ready to fight this one. Yeah, there's Pegasus with his Toon World field, and then that's... What? Bandit Keith with the... I forget what it's called. I forget what the name of the flag, the British flag is called. It's like the equivalent of Stars and Stripes for American one. I can't remember what it's called. Union Jack? Is that what it's called?
Oh, I'm Bandit Keith in Britain. Or in the UK. I'm Bandit Keith in Britain.
I just did the same thing twice. I was trying to say the UK, but it didn't work. Rex, and then there's Stonehenge again. Alright, let me look into my deck. I want to see if I can just throw a Cocoon of Evolution in there. I want to know what the actual effect is. I kept meaning to check it. Oh, cool, I have Kaiser Dragon. I have a lot of dragons, actually. So you would think you would just, like, build the best deck you can, but if you look at the DC, which is the deck cost, that has to be lower than the opponent we face. And I think at some point, there's an opponent that kind of comes up in the middle that's, like, purposely has one, like, the same as Rex's, because Rex... Or the same as Weevils, so that like forces you to take cards out of your deck. I don't remember it perfectly though. Okay, let's try to remember how to do this. Nope, hang on. L1? No. Is it... So, L1 and R1's up. So, oh, it's just left and right? That was too easy. Trying to look into its special ability. changes Larva Moth, Petite Moth, Caterpillar, Needleworm, and Acid Crawler to Larva Moth. Larva of Moth. So I need one of those, which means I need to fight Weevil again and get one of those. So I thought it was too good to be true, and that's not how this works at all. Kakuna Evolution is absolutely its own card, but whatever. So I'd need one of those to do this. I guess that's a good way of balancing it, though. I can't get too mad. And then what does Fake Trap actually do? Disposable trap that triggers when Harpy's Feather Duster is activated and nullifies the card's effect. Yeah, so it's meant to be a junk trap, or it's meant to be junk, as in, hey, you lost. Tough shit. I'm trying to remember if he has any leader abilities yet. No. Now, you could theoretically change the leader to anyone, I think only a few can do. I forget how it works. I think he starts off with a higher rank, which will go up, as that's what the star means. I think it goes up the more you use it, but I think you can change it to a different one, but I don't fully remember it. We can try it. Let's, trying to think. I definitely want to fight Weevil again, but I'll do that off screen, but I want to try and smash my head against Rex, because I will not be able to beat him. Not with this deck. The Rose Duelist, eh? I'm not, it's the same voice as Weevil. I'm not impressed. In fact, I'll crush you to a pulp with my Dino deck. He would not say Dinosaur. He would say Dino. Alright, let's just beat Rex, and then we've only got 6 more duelists, and then we beat the game. It's that easy. No trouble whatsoever. So, Rex's stage is a little bit more of a pain in the ass. So, these are Labyrinth fields, which I think only like a couple monsters in the entire game can move through. So for all intents and purposes, it's just a block. So we can only use these wasteland cards. Like basically we can only go up these pillars, which is a cool design, but really annoying. So I think if I do get mountain, then I can change it. So I can have mountain override the labyrinth ones and potentially create like a shortcut, but I have to get it first. Okay, special info, weakens an opponent's enemy by 300 points when destroyed in battle. I like that. And then I want to hold off on Wall of Illusion just in case he starts sending something towards me. So let's go with these for now. Nothing. Alright, well, just send them forward. Okay, so they can move by one. They can move one space if they're face down and two if they're face up. That's how that works. Alright, this is sure to go perfectly. Nothing will go wrong. Alright, let's summon one on this side. There's an adhesive trap, or disposable that triggers against a monster with 1,000 or below attack. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to fight anyone like that, but thank you. Let me just go without it, I guess. No summoning this turn. I'm going to save up my points. I'm trying to get Kaiser Dragon. I think if you fuse the monsters in your hand, it goes by whatever the highest attack point monster in your hand was. Oh wow, was not expecting to actually beat him. I'll take this. I'll watch my monster actually destroy someone. That'll be a nice change of pace. So this is wasteland for some reason. I don't know why it's also a bunch of canyons. So can someone explain to me why this card, not this one, Twin-Headed Dark Ruler, or Twin-Mouth Dark, I forgot what that one's called. Can someone explain to me why that card doesn't fuse into Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon? Is it literally just because Twin-Headed Thunder Dragon, they're like, oh, obviously you fuse two Thunder Dragons. Like Two-Mouth Dark Ruler looks exactly like it, but just a smaller green version. It's always bugged me. Alright, what do I have going up this way? Nothing. So yeah, if I do this, I think it'll only take 4. Actually, let me do... Oh, he gained up. He must have gained points. I thought he wasn't that strong. He gained points because of mountain. Or not mountain, forest. That makes sense. Actually, let me get rid of a... That was of adhesive traps. If this works the same way it does in Forbidden Memories, then the trap will bounce right off him. Or not. That works too. Cool. All right, now I'm close. He's definitely going to summon... So this is where it's not quite as easy as when I was fighting Weevil, because he can just summon a monster behind him, and that'll block my advance. Not to mention he has stronger monsters. Oh, it's Robbie. This does not work well for me. Damn it. Again, not expecting to beat Rex, but I thought I'd try it. It's better than when I was choosing which Yu-Gi-Oh game to originally Let's Play, and I chose Falsebound Kingdom. When I showed footage of this game, Weevil just mollywalked me. He just like just kicked the shit out of me. So this is a better alternative, I think. So if I can use that with Sky Dragon, I might have a decent shot. Especially if I can put Mountain down too. So I'll leave that for now. Actually. Yeah, because I'm going to try and clear my hand when I do it too, so. I'll just end my turn. Also, I don't know if anybody noticed, but you start off with 4,000 life points instead of 8,000, which thank God. Just thank God. Oh my God, I can't imagine if this game had more than that. Okay, so I'm going to try and fuse... trying to clear my hand, honestly. There we go. Power increase. 2400. That's decent. I don't think it's the strongest. It'll be the strongest card in the field, but it'll stand a good chance. Oh, I can still only move one. Okay. Well, I'll do that. And then let a Robbie try and come at me. He still hasn't really summoned anyone down the path, but I only have House of Adhesive Tape, so doing well so far. Also, Sky Dragon, absolutely not a dragon. That motherfucker is clearly a winged beast. Look at those feathery wings. Aw, poor Robbie. I like a Robbie, but I mean, it needs to die so that I may live. Also, that is not the kind of attack a Robbie would do. A Robbie would just come running at me chomping. Me and a Robbie, we're good friends. Also, my dragon is very clearly a bird. I don't know how I can make this more clear. I don't know why, but for some reason, that's funny to me. It looks ridiculous. Man, I can't wait until I start getting Blue Eyes and all the other ones. All those cards they showed me in that epileptic trailer. That'll be, or the epileptic opening movie. That'll be pretty cool. Alright. Awesome. Why is it spellbound? I don't understand why that happened. I didn't think Arabi had an ability, but apparently he does. How long are you spellbound for? One more turn. Okay. I can live with that. Realistically. What do you do? This card is still face up. Strength is Lord of the Lamp by 700 points. Alright, that's not happening. I want to try and send a monster down the other way so I can... Oh, wow. What do those two make? Bean Soldier. Okay. I want to try and send a monster down the other way so I can cause a pincer against Two-Headed King Rex, but it's going to take some time. Also, I should have summoned him over here and then moved him. Whatever. It's a Sky Dragon move again. Luckily, he's... Oh, no. He's moving forward. He's got a monster stronger than me. Show me Mountain. Uh-oh. Whenever damage inflicted the life points, battle damage reduces to zero. I like that. Ghoul with an appetite. I guess... Oh, it's a zombie, so I forgot. Zombies are powered up by Wasteland. Maybe... Let me try and throw Ghoul with an appetite there. But I also want to summon all of these, too, so I can get that out of the way. Alright. I can, let me just go right over. House of Adhesive Tape. That should work. Okay. I'm gonna be brave. I don't know why he's got a monster coming after me, but it's probably not gonna end well for me. Oh no, he's balking now. He was fronting on me. Okay, so I'm definitely gonna move that way. I thought he had a stronger monster. Alright, where the fuck... Okay, it does show me how many cards are in my deck too. I don't remember if you deck out, if that's an instant game over in this one. This I do want to try. I want to see if you can combine these to get a stronger monster. Nope. Okay. You're just fodder. You stay there. We move you back down. Move you forward. Move you up. And then move. You already moved up. Okay, so kind of closing in on him. He takes as long as possible to like not attack, which is nice. I wonder if he's trying to let Sky Dragon out of the way so he can try and throw a monster towards me. Come on, really? Also, that is Karibo. Don't call it Wretched Ghost of the Attic. That is not a real thing. I gotta wait a turn to let my stars come back. Okay. Let's keep moving up. I wasn't expecting this, but I could have a chance here. I really do wonder why I can't move. Could you move two turns because of the field? That must be it. I don't know why I thought that. Shout out to the people who are commenting things, being like, well, actually, you can do this because of this. And then, you know, I think I realize it later in the video. Because I know there's going to be a few of you. So, shouts out to you guys. All right, I'll summon him right in Petite Dragon. So, let's make it so Curtain of the Dark Ones is last, because he has Spellbound. Or, because he's a good defense card, I should say. If I can get, if I can get Mountain up there somehow. In fact, I might even want to move him up. If I can flip Mountain, like, right here, that'll really fuck Rex over. Which I am all about. Alright, do I want to do my attacks simultaneously? I think so. I'm willing to bet that's not an actual monster. But I'll wait, because he's not going to move until I get too close enough, I don't think. Yeah, so he's trapping himself. Oh man, he's got that card coming straight at me. Now it's a battle of who can get there first. Okay, he also did place a monster that way. Mountain, okay, here we go. Also, what do you do? When this card is flipped face up, all cards located in sea terrain are destroyed. Cool. Alright, so no fudging around here. I'm gonna do that. Play that. And then I don't know if that'll be enough to, if I can take out these labyrinth cards, that'll be good. Yeah, let me try this. So I'm pretty sure this destroys. Oh, that's awkward. I was pretty sure that they got rid of the labyrinth ones. That's, ooh, that's yeah, I knew that was a spell card. That's unfortunate. Hopefully I can send him down the other way though. Little D. Story of my life. Penis jokes. Okay, let's not watch this destruction of Little D. Okay, so if I'm lucky, he'll move straight down. Why does it keep spellbinding me? This is not cool. Yeah, if I'm lucky, he'll be like, oh, this ghoul with an appetite. Oh, he can't move down that way. So he's going to be forced to move this way. And then he'll summon something in between ghoul with an appetite. Yeah, he just went right over his own card, which was a spell, I now know. That is a ballsy move. Oh, red medicine. He summons over there instead of actually summoning a monster between him. Which might just mean he's saving up his spell, his star chips. So he's trying to summon a better monster. That could totally be what it is. I don't really have much else. Ooh, I have Kaiser Dragon, which is super strong here. What do you do again? Flip all enemy cards in the field face up. I'm about that life. Let me try that. Yeah, I don't know what that card over in the corner is, but I don't like it. Actually, he only has one card, so that's not super worth it yet. Trying to, if I can move my Deckmaster in this little safe area, and that way if someone tries to attack me over here, I'll be good. I think I'm in a pretty good position as it is. If I flip up, can I not? I have to be starting on the field, I think. I have to be starting on the Wasteland tile. Alright, I can do this. He is standing straight still. I don't know what his plan here is, but Rex, I don't know what your motivation is. Ooh, I'll take that. Mutually assured destruction is fine with me. As now Sky Dragon can sort of move in. Okay, come on, let's move forward. Yep, I know. I keep trying to press start because that's how you activate everything else in this game. Yeah! I mean, I would have heard if I'd won, but that's fine. I can take that too. Okay, let me see. What can I actually summon? Kaiser Dragon I should be going for, so let me try this. Move that forward. I might just not use that card, which is fine. If I flip it face up, no, it doesn't work for some reason. Okay, so let's move right over Dark Piercing Light. Moving on in. It's happening, guys. I think Kaiser Dragon is the strongest card in my deck, too, so if I had waited and done Dragon Treasure with that, it would have been a lot better. Now he's on the run. I finally have that pincer maneuver I wanted. That's probably a spell. There we go. So that's... Oh, because then he can't move, so... That's not that great. I didn't move it at all. That was a worse decision. Okay. Winged Dragon Guardian the Fortress number 2. You don't see that very often. Okay, I don't really have a plan, other than to just keep throwing monsters at him, but maybe it would be better to back up and try and reinforce over here. So Flame Ghost works. Let's see if I can make a Zombie Dragon or something. Also, definitely really hoping decking out isn't a thing here, because I am not ready for it if it is. Cool. Crawling or Zombie Dragon is exactly what I needed here. Okay, he is not affected by Wasteland, so doesn't help if I go face up. Oh, it's actually a monster, Mega Zaller too. Ooh, he should have just gone in defense position, and then he would have beaten me. I would have been able to get past him. It would have been a perfect defense. But he had the greed. He had to play it in attack position. Stop spellbinding me. I don't know why this is happening. Do you have an effect that makes you get spellbound every time you're fucking attacked? This is bullshit. I don't know why it's happening, and it annoys me. Okay, he just flat out didn't move, which is a ballsy strategy. Yeah, he's trying to come around the other side to get me, and that's not going to work for him. Okay, let's keep dragon zombie up there. Get it, guys? Dragon. Dragging. Haha. Comedy. Alright, so that works. Got him over there now. I think if you corner him, so I have Armored Lizard here now. If he summons a monster, if say Kaiser Dragon got right here, I think you automatically win because he can't summon any monsters. Which is cool because sometimes you can beat stronger opponents that way just by getting lucky. I am shocked he didn't move right over it. Okay, let me try this. Perfect. I think I win. I think that's my victory. Hey, I had that same card. Was not expecting to beat Rex either, but alright. I'll take it. I'll take this beginner's luck, because it's gonna slam me later. This luck is not gonna continue for me. Can it still technically summon? That's weird to me. Maybe it has to start the next turn? I could have sworn if you, it automatically gives you a game over if you can't summon anyone. He definitely has no summoning spots, so I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. Maybe it's because he still has a card on the field that's not a game over. Yeah, that must be it. No, here it is. Oh my god, I was scared. I was like, am I going to get a game over because I can't draw any cards? Neato. So I think you can get any cards that appeared in that duel. Mega Zaller would be pretty cool. Yeah, or Twin-Headed King Rex. I'm gonna try and go for Mega Zaller. It's hard to see. It's like slightly dark on the top and bottom. Oh, Nick. Could you be any better at this? Okay, let's go for Twin-Headed King Rex. Oh, I can barely see it. Ah, it was close. Let's go for Twin-Headed King Rex again. No. Damn it, I got so close. I'll take Megazalar, though. That's all. I'm all about that life. All right. So, yeah, I think that was a very successful first part.
What, me? Lose? I don't believe it!
Rex is slightly more gruff than Weevil. That's the difference. They do sound more or less the same. All right, new unlock. That's Panic, the Dark Field. I don't know what the one over here is. Bones. Yeah, see, so Bones, you need 795, which means you actually are required to get less card or less deck cost than you start out with, which is bananas. And then there's Darkness Ruler, which is just Panic. I don't know why they called him Darkness Ruler. That's weird. Then Pegasus Crawford. And then Keith. Why is he not? Why is he only a bandit when he's from America? That's racism. That's nationalism. That's jingoist. That's xenophobic. I think xenophobic might be it. All right, I'm gonna save. And that was a successful first part. I'm calling it, guys. We did it. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Eventually, maybe. I don't know. Maybe sooner than later if people liked it. If not, I'm sorry I wasted your time. I'll go back to Digimon very shortly. Thank you, and goodbye.